done in an effort to reduce the limitations of startups. The government has issued new norms. Remember, the startups had already been bothered by the angel tax issue, and these new rules comes as a breather for the company. Shireen Bhan joins us now to give us the details on this. Shireen, over to you.
Well, thanks very much. The DIPP has issued a gazette notification simplifying the process for startups to get exemption on investments under Section 56(2), which has basically been come to known as the angel tax. Now, what they basically said is that the limit for exemption has been enhanced from 10 crore rupees currently to about 25 crore rupees. Secondly, what they've also done to encourage domestic capital to come into startups is that startups by listed companies with a net worth of 100 crore rupees or a turnover of 250 crore rupees will be exempt from Section 56. Also, the definition of a startup has now been enhanced. An entity shall be considered a startup up to 10 years from its date of incorporation instead of the existing 7-year period. To deal with the kind of coercive action that we were seeing on account of the Income Tax Department, which had to do with issues related to valuation, the DIPP Gazette notification says that the valuation of shares will no longer be a criteria for exemption of investments into eligible startups under Section 56. But it's also important to note that Section 68, which has also been used by the Income Tax Department to freeze accounts and to take action against startups, there has not been any specific clarification issued by the DIPP by way of this Gazette notification on Section 68. So that remains to be seen. But on the face of it, this is positive news for startups. The question now is whether this will actually be implemented in letter and spirit.
All right. Thanks, Shireen, for joining us and putting all that into perspective. The startup space is really gaining importance, and this is going to give a leg up in some ways as well. Now, moving on to the stock of the day. The stock is Imami, which is gaining almost 13% in trade as we speak, as the promoters really divest a 10% stake in the company. And Anisha joins in with all the details of that development. Anisha.
Hi, Anisha. Good afternoon. Well, as you mentioned, Imami Limited is in focus because the promoter group, that is Imami Group, has let go of 10% stake at a value of 1,600 crore rupees, and they have sold it to a lot of mutual funds like SBI Mutual Fund, L&T Mutual Fund, as well as IDFC, etc. Now, the reason, as you mentioned, it is to fund the promoter's debt, as well as that the debt they have taken for their cement as well as power assets, and the brokerages use this as a positive action. The promoter's holding as well will come down to around 62.7%. Not only that, is this good for the company's overall leverage as well as promoter leverage, the fact that the overhang of pledges go away is another positive. Also, if you look at the market valuation for this particular deal, it has been done very close to the current market price, and that also helps to assuage the investor concerns. Macquarie, for example, has a target price of 430. They maintain a neutral call on the stock, but given the fact it is a very positive action from the management and shows the kind of confidence that Street has on the stock is gaining around 10-12% as we speak.
Okay, thanks a lot for that, Anisha. We'll take a quick break on that note, but do watch out for the biggest event of the year, the News 18 Rising India Summit, which will be held in New Delhi on the 25th and 26th of February. This is one platform where you can catch all the biggest newsmakers of the country, from Prime Minister Narendra Modi, BJP President Amit Shah, to opposition chief ministers Kamalnath and Bhupesh Baghel. Along with a host of union ministers will be Isha Foundation founder Sadhguru, Bollywood and sports icons like Deepika Padukone and former coach of the Indian cricket team Anil Kumble. That's the News 18 Rising India Summit in New Delhi on the 25th and 26th of February.